Welcome to this video, which is a preview of the online course on quarterly national accounts and high-frequency indicators of economic activity, or QNAX. Before diving in, let's start by answering the following question. Why are these indicators important? As you may know, a country's national accounts provide policymakers with macroeconomic data that they can use for many relevant tasks, such as monitoring the economy, macroeconomic analysis, and international comparisons. Although the annual national accounts are generally based on the most reliable and comprehensive data, the time required to collect, prepare, and disseminate them is not suitable for short-term analysis. Policymakers need more frequent and timely data to deal with events such as inflation, recessions, and supply chain disruptions. Here is where quarterly national accounts can help, as they are designed to meet this need. For example, economic growth, as measured by changes in real GDP, is one indicator of an economy's health. In most countries, these estimates are only available quarterly and with significant lags. Economic monitoring and policy decision-making, however, are carried out more frequently and based on the most recent periods. Most countries meet this need by producing high-frequency indicators of economic activity. These indicators might be available at a quarterly, monthly, or even weekly frequency. These are some of the important facts that you will learn if you take the complete QNAX course. Specifically, you will learn the basics of how quarterly national accounts and high-frequency indicators of economic activity are compiled and estimated, including the required data sources and the calculation of volume measures. You will also learn how and why to perform benchmarking and seasonal adjustment and dissemination policies. Please consider the IMF Quarterly National Accounts Manual as a reference for this course. Then, if you like what you see in this preview video, don't miss the chance to register for the full online course at the link located on the video's description. We hope you enjoy this preview of the Quarterly National Accounts course.
The role of Quarterly National Accounts, or QNA, is to provide a picture of current economic developments that is timelier than the Annual National Accounts, or ANA, and more comprehensive than provided by high-frequency indicators. To meet this goal, the QNA should be timely, coherent, accurate, comprehensive, and reasonably detailed. If the QNA fulfill these criteria, they can serve as a framework for assessing, analyzing, and monitoring current economic developments. By providing quarterly data on economic aggregates in a coherent accounting framework, based on the system of national accounts, the QNA allow analysis of dynamic relationships between these aggregates. Thus, the QNA provide the basic data for business cycle analysis and economic modeling. This example shows quarterly and annual GDP data from 2010 to 2014. Note that for this example, we have rescaled the annual GDP, shown with a single blue line for each year, to equal the average of the quarterly GDP for each year. In fact, the annual GDP is equal to the sum of the quarterly GDP, except for those countries that rescale their quarterly GDP to show the annual rate. The quarterly data show that the economy was declining from the first quarter of 2010 until the first quarter of 2012, after which it moved up until the first quarter of 2013. Then, GDP turned down for the next three quarters and finally began growing again in the last three quarters of 2014. In contrast, the annual data show the economy contracting from 2010 to 2012, even though the QNA showed that GDP had turned up after the first quarter of 2012. The first indication of that upturn doesn't appear in the annual data until the data for 2013 are published, by which time the QNA data show the economy has already gone through a second downturn. Clearly, the ANA data are not frequent or timely enough to provide practical guidance about business cycles to economic policymakers. The objective of the Monthly Indicators of Economic Growth, or MIEG, is to track the evolution of real GDP on a monthly basis. The specific components and methods of compilation will depend on data availability, but developing consistent sources and methods will help ensure consistent results. It may be necessary to compile some components based on indirect information or estimation methods. To ensure timeliness, it may be necessary to fill data gaps with imputations or estimates until more complete source data can be incorporated in the next scheduled revision of the indicator. The coverage of the MIEG is usually based on either the GDP compiled by the production approach, which covers the major industrial activities of the economy, or the expenditure approach, which covers the major components of final consumption expenditure, gross capital formation, exports and imports. The MIEG will usually include a main indicator that is conceptually similar to GDP in volume terms, another series that represent components or groups of components within the overall aggregates. When possible, the indicator should be seasonally adjusted. The difference between quarterly and monthly indicators in terms of the additional information provided by the higher frequency is illustrated by this chart that shows the annual, quarterly, and monthly measures of GDP that were published by the Office for National Statistics of the United Kingdom. We see that the monthly data allow much more precise timing of the pandemic-related downturn in 2020, which occurred primarily in March and April. The monthly data show that by June, the economy had turned up, while the quarterly data don't show the upturn until the third quarter. The MIEG can be used to provide early identification of business cycle turning points. This will provide information to policymakers who need to assess the state of the economy and implement macroeconomic policies. It may also be used to provide forecasts, for example, of quarterly or annual GDP, of tax revenue, and other important economic variables. It can be used to investigate issues around seasonality and seasonal adjustment, benchmarking, consistency of monthly indicators with QNA, and sources of revisions. Presenting data in the time series format facilitates the identification of underlying trends and turning points. It allows different periods to be compared and the calculation of growth rates. To be comparable over time, the time series should have the following characteristics. Observations of a time series should measure the same concept over time. Measurement of the same concept should be consistent over time with respect to statistical standards and units of measurement. Time periods should be in the same unit, for example, months or quarters. Periods of different lengths are not comparable. Data should be available in a discrete form. For example, quarterly national accounts should be compiled and disseminated in quarterly discrete form. Cumulative data, such as data presenting year-to-date totals, do not constitute time series. Observations of a cumulative series cannot be compared because they measure periods of time with different lengths. For the effective use of a time series, the data should cover a sufficient number of periods. At least 5 years of data are normally required in order to conduct basic time series analysis and to perform seasonal adjustment. Time series facilitate the analysis of developments over time in a flexible manner. Economic time series are often characterized by recurrent seasonal effects. The weather directly affects certain types of production, such as agriculture and construction. Societies also have traditions or laws that establish seasonal patterns for vacations, public holidays, and religious observances, which affect output and expenditures. These factors lead to regular seasonal patterns in economic time series, including GDP. We see from the chart that United States real GDP without seasonal adjustment shows regular seasonal patterns. Typically, GDP peaks in the fourth quarter when retail sales are boosted by seasonal gift giving and declines in the first quarter when cold weather and winter storms dampen production, especially for outdoor industries such as construction. Seasonal adjustment is the process of removing seasonal and calendar effects from a time series. The purpose of seasonal adjustment is to provide users with additional series where the regular season and calendar effects have been removed. This allows the user to focus on the non-seasonal effects that are of more interest to policymakers and analysts. In the chart, we see that the seasonally adjusted real GDP series does not exhibit the regular first quarter decline that appeared each year in the unadjusted series. The seasonally adjusted series does not, however, remove all declines. It retains the large decline in the first and second quarters of 2020 that was associated with the COVID-19 pandemic. Thus, by eliminating the routine seasonal patterns, the seasonally adjusted series highlights the more meaningful events and cycles. Let's call a time series XT, where the subscript T indicates that the series has data points for each period T. The series can be decomposed into three components, one for long-term trends and cyclical movements, TT, another for seasonal and calendar-related effects, ST plus CT, and finally an irregular component that can be considered random, IT. The seasonally adjusted data retain the trend cycle and irregular components, but remove the seasonal component. The seasonally adjusted QNA series are used to identify cyclical turning points that can indicate the beginning and end of recessions. Analysts may also be interested in the trend cycle component, which removes both the seasonal and irregular components.